A bartender once asked a patron, "Hey, what's the matter?" The guy at the bar replied, "Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space." But no, seriously, what is matter? Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. It's one of the basic things you learn about in science class, the difference between solids, liquids, and gases. Objects can move through different states of matter depending on the density of their particles. Solids exist when their particles become so densely packed together they don't move around so much, and their atoms don't move at all, they're in a fixed position. Solids don't change shape based on what container they're in. In liquids, atoms can move freely, but they remain touching. These particles are held together by weak intermolecular attraction. You might remember that it takes the shape of whatever container it's in, but still retains a consistent density. Gases, on the other hand, have no volume or real shape. Their molecules are too far apart, but they bounce against each other a lot, so a gas will expand indefinitely. Because of this bouncing, gases have a high kinetic energy. Plasma, while not so common here on Earth, is found throughout the universe, and might even be the most abundant form of matter in the universe. You might recognize plasma in that glowing gas that makes neon signs glow, or maybe from our sun, which is just a big ball of burning gas roiling into a plasma. When gas gets energized, electrons get freed from atoms and make ions, turning the gas into a plasma. Plasmas, like gas, take the shape of whatever container they're in and are really good conductors for magnetic energy and electricity. So that's the big four states of matter, but is that all there is to the story? Just like the recent additions to the periodic table were made in a lab, so were these new states of matter. Bose-Einstein condensates, degenerate matter, supersolids and superfluids, and quark gluon plasma, which is created inside of particle accelerators. And the latest addition, Jahn-Teller metals. An international team of researchers published their findings in the journal Science Advances. The researchers created a new type of material that could change the way we make electronics. This metal does all kinds of things. It acts like an insulator, superconductor, metal, and magnet. But its superconducting properties are the most interesting. Superconductors are super exciting. They're currently used in MRI machines, making digital circuits, and in highly sensitive scientific equipment, like particle detectors. These materials can transfer electricity without resistance or losing any energy through heat or sound. Unfortunately, these materials only work when it's super cold, like negative 405 degrees Fahrenheit, which costs a lot of money to cool down. But this discovery can conduct at a high critical temperature, negative 211 degrees, which could be cheaper and more versatile. The material is composed of buckyballs, which are a type of round molecule made up of carbon. Rubidium atoms put pressure on these molecules and control the distance between them, changing the phases the material goes through. It can shift from an insulator to a metal. Let me put that in English. By changing the pressure on the material, it can change the way it conducts electricity. It doesn't conduct well at low pressure and basically acts like an insulator, but at high pressure, it becomes a metal. But during this transition, it's in a state that's never been seen before. It still looks like an insulator, but the electrons can move around just like in a conductor. But we're still a long way off from using this material practically, but it's still really cool. It could be one step away to high temperature superconductivity. Speaking of what's the matter, what about dark matter? We may have evidence that it exists. Julian breaks down the subatomic particles and explains why in this video here.
While the discovery is fascinating, I want to take a minute to explain in depth what he means by baryonic particles, because it's something that links the very, very, very small to the supermassive.
What's your favorite state of matter? I like plasma. Let us know down in the comments below and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.